And that segues into what I wanted to ask you about was the stoppage. For me, as I'm watching, I'm like, okay, he's not even fighting back. He's just a punching bag now. And fair, he was hurt. He was bleeding from everywhere. But the guy was just pummeling
him. The proper move, the compassionate thing, the right thing to do. I'm glad you brought it up. Listen, does that mean it's right? Because I think it's right. No, but I can only go by 40 years of experience. Rob asked me a question earlier when we were answering some of the questions for people out there. We actually answer questions. Why shouldn't we? We're answering questions because I appreciate them. We appreciate them. So we want to give something back. So they wrote today before you got here for an hour. I stood here. Rob took your place.
Oh.
Yeah, Rob took your place.
That's how Bledsoe lost his job.
Yeah, we were talking about it earlier. And I can only, Rob asked a question. Right to the point. What would you do? Matter of fact, it was one of the questions from the fans. What would you do? You got to think about it, you know. I would have did the same thing.
Would you have done it before you told him in between rounds? Because I like when the trainer says, if you don't show me something, I got to stop
this. I'm just saying, at that point, dealing with what was there,
yeah,
I would have done the same thing.
Regardless of any conversation.
Yeah, well, yeah. Well, I mean, if it's the same thing, I would say the same scenario that I hadn't had a conversation, whatever.
Yeah.
I see what I see. I'm stopped because he was hurt. He was a punch away from being hurt bad.
Yes.
And listen, you want to go a little further? You want to run it through? You want to let it run? He's going to be on the floor, I believe. Mm-hmm. He's going to be on the floor, and who knows what happens. It happens in boxing. And listen, do I understand that, you know, warrior mentality? Yeah, that's for the fighter. But for the people protecting him, whether it's the referee or his corner, for me, the corner has that responsibility and the referee. You got to think of what's right for the fighter. Mm-hmm. And he's got heart, plenty of heart. But if the fighter has heart that a fighter is supposed to have, then you protect him from himself. But you have to make the right quick decision there. And he was gone. He was wobbling for a long time. But at that point, he had just made a nice move. Fury actually was the best move of the night, if my memory is correct. He stepped back and stepped back in with a straight right hand. It was a beautiful move. Because when you step back, you make the guy lurch a little bit. Mm-hmm. You create something. And then, bop, he stepped right back in. And I saw it and I said, oh, he's gone. This is it.
Yeah.
And then he's about to hit him, unload with a fusillade of punches. And the fight got stopped. So I'm going to go further. So for me, yeah, it was, and you know, I think it's terrible that they're probably going to fire Mark Breland.
I think so.
Who was a great amateur, one of our great amateur fighters.
Because even the other trainer came out and said, I didn't know he was going to do that and I wouldn't have done it.
And throwing him under the bus.
But
I'm just saying that I'm defending him. Do I have to? No. But I feel I do because I'm in the business and I got to say what I think is right. Some people are going to go the other way. But I think he did the right thing. I think he did the compassion. And I'll say one other thing. The other trainer, who's the head trainer, I guess, he's got no background as a fighter as far as I'm concerned. Who better to make that decision and to understand that than a former fighter?
That's a good point.
And a tremendous former fighter. Mm-hmm. Really. Ken, Mark Breland was like 110-1 as an amateur. 5-time New York Gold Glove champion. Back in the day when it was one of the most competitive tournaments, the Gold Gloves, New York Daily News Gold Gloves doesn't exist anymore. One of the most competitive tournaments in the country. I mean, it was tremendous. You had to win like five, six fights, and good fighters. Really high quality. He won it 5 times, and he won a gold medal in the Olympics, and he won a world title in the pros. And he wasn't as good a pro as people thought he would be. He wasn't, because he didn't have the physicality for the 10, 12 rounds, like I was kind of talking about. Yeah. A good amateur doesn't translate into a goal. But he won a world title. He won a welterweight title against a South African, I think named Volbrick. I can't believe I remember these things. And I believe he was a southpaw. And I'm going to tell you a little secret. You want to hear a little secret?
Mm-hmm.
It's okay. It's not hurting.
No one else is listening.
It's not hurting nobody. He went into that. You take advantage of your opportunity, right, Ken?
Yeah.
Sometimes your opportunity might never come again. So what do you do? This is for the people out there that are going through these things. This is really for you. That sometimes, you know, you say, I can't do it because I feel sick. I can't do it. I got a stomach virus. I can't make the meeting. But you have a meeting with someone who could change your life. No, I can't. I don't feel good. And you don't do it, right?
Everyone has gone through that conversation.
I'll wait till the next time. Next time never comes. Mark Breland was getting ready to fight this guy. I know his trainer was a good friend of mine, mm-hmm. Joey Ferriello. Great trainer. Mm-hmm. Great person. I miss him. And he came down, the only other guy to come down the same path as me. Guess who he was a protege of? Customano, before me. And he had a falling out like I did at the end with him? Joey Ferriello. Similar path. We became friends later because of that. Mm-hmm. And we worked in the same gym together for years, Gleason's. And he was getting ready to fight, I think it was Harold Volbrick, for the welterweight title. And Breland broke his hand. Nobody knows this. And he broke his hand. He's got a broken hand. So fight's off, right, Ken?
Yeah.
No. No. Joey, Mark, Joey's the head. They understand. This was the right guy to fight. You got him. But if you don't fight him, you might never get this fight again. If you pull out because of a broken hand, someone else is going to fight him, and maybe a better guy becomes the champion, and the opportunity passes.
One quick thing, that reminds me of you when you fought. Was it when Michael fought Holyfield, and you said, if you don't step up right now, the next guy is going to beat him?
Yes. This was the moment. You got to grab your moment. You got to grab your moment. I'm going to say it a third time, Ken. You got to grab your moment. Forget about diarrhea. No, really. Really. Forget about all that other stuff. Grab your moment. Believe. Grab it. And Joey Ferriello, a real trainer. There's not a lot of real trainers around. And a teacher. Not too many of them around. He says, no. We'll get the hand fixed later. You know, I'm not putting your life in jeopardy. I'm not putting you. It's a tough pill. Oh, that's tough, Teddy. Whoa, that's tough. We're not in the opera business. We're in the boxing fight business. Life is a fight too. And you know what? Sometimes you got to fight with a bloody nose. Sometimes you got to fight with a broken hand. And we'll get it fixed later. There's going to be time to fix it later. But there might never be a time to win this title the way we can win it now. You're winning it now. With a broken hand. He went out there, knocked him out in four rounds. I believe four rounds. Rob, the truth will all come out, but I know I'm close. And here we go, baby.
I thought it was really unfair criticism because Wilder said it in the ring as well. It kind of threw him under the bus. He said, you know, my corner threw in the towel. I want to go out on my
shield. It was unfair. Well, but that's the point, is that Mark Breland did the right thing. And again, who is better suited, Ken, to make that decision than a guy, and I'm not knocking the other guy. Mm-hmm. He's the head trainer. But he never fought, as far as I know. Mm-hmm. Who's better suited, him or Mark Breland? I just went through all this stuff with Mark Breland to make the point. Yeah. Who's better suited to make that freaking decision? Yeah. I think Breland. And he made a decision, and now he's being ostracized for it. He's going to be fired. He's going, whatever. But he knew. This is a guy who fought with a broken hand. So it's not like he's not afraid to face, you know, danger or risk, you know. But this is a different risk. This is a guy who's semi-conscious. He knows where he's at. He knows what's coming next. He did the right thing. He might have saved his life. I don't want to be over-dramatic.
No, but you're right.
But and he did the right thing. And for me, the fighter should stand up for him. I get it.
I have a feeling he will. I think when the dust settles, they're going to say, you know what?
I know for the people out there, they're going to say, but wait a minute, Teddy. Your own words. I'm starting to sound like Stephen A. Smith. I love Stephen A. Wait a minute, Teddy. Your own words. He always has that eraser. So he can still come back. You know, the eraser don't mean diddly squat when your legs are gone.
Yep.
When your mind is gone.
Yeah.
When you're no longer there. Because guess what? Yeah, the razor, where is it? Is it down there? No, it's up here. To be delivered, it needs down here. Mm-hmm. It needs down here to be set. Down here was gone. Down here was out to lunch. It went north of Dakota somewhere. So to deliver this, this had to be here. So you could still have that puncher's chance. He didn't have it no more.